We're here today in the heart of Durham, once a quiet, tranquil city, transformed overnight by violent gang warfare. We hope to shed more light on the situation by speaking to the gangs, the Bleach Boys and the Grain, and to find out more from the locals about the effects on everyday life.
People used to be happy and friendly here, living safely within the city, until the gangs arrived and crime with them, spreading panic and poverty among these once quiet streets. Despite asking the police and local papers for information, we were given no further insight, so we took to asking people on the street.
We're going to talk to the locals now about the gang warfare. Most of them have been unresponsive so far. We'll see what happens this time. Excuse me, could you spare a few minutes to talk to us about the gang warfare? It's not happening. Hi, could you talk to us about the gang warfare in Durham? Hi, do you mind speaking to us? No, no one's listening.
Eventually, we found a concerned parent willing to speak about their experience.
It's not safe for my kids to hurl abuse at university students at bus stations anymore.
We tried to speak to an addict.
Fuck off! Fuck off! Go away!
But he wouldn't cooperate. With clearly unhappy parents and angry addicts, we made some phone calls and organised meetings with both of the so-called gangs, though they were reluctant to be filmed.
We're on our way to film an interview with the supposed leader of the Grain Gang.
He didn't seem enthused to meet us.
We understand that you're the head of the Durham Mafia. Could you perhaps tell us a bit more about your everyday routine?
Everyday routine? Well, what I can say about our operation is that it's professional in every concern. Every member contributes his part into the whole Grain, and they will work to earn their dough. But if they fail, I will slice them.
You kill them?
Let's just say their reputation crumbles.
So you kill them?
You trying to get a rise out of me?
No, no, sir. I'm just trying to verify the rumours.
These are tales you talk about. They do have some truth to them. I mean, recently we have been expanding our business.
Well, what can I say? Our operation needs to grow.
But what about your men? I've heard there's been losses on both sides.
Let me go straight here. If something happens, I will have a part of it. You see, nothing happens without me knowing. I'm quite sorry, this interview will have to go over.
Actually,
undeterred, there was still a gang left to interview.
We're on our way now to speak to the Bleach Boys. Hi, hi, thanks for meeting with us. Right, so I've heard you're the head of the Bleach Boys, is that correct?
Yeah, that's right. This is my crew. We got the mules, we got the purifiers, and we got the admin. And I delegate. This is my brothers, you know. If you mess with us, we mess with you. Yin yang and all that.
Right, so have you got anything to say about the criticism that you've received from the public about your actions?
Wait, let me get this straight. You say violence, I say self-defense. You say conflict, I say negotiation.
Negotiation?
Negotiation. We're gonna put these posh boys in a pit of despair, you know what I'm saying?
I didn't know what she was saying. I spent the rest of the day with the Bleach Boys. They taught me many things about their business, their culture, about life in general. Unfortunately, we only got footage of one of their many rituals. I wish that every kiss was ever ending. I didn't understand. That evening, the Grain invited us to see their distribution centre so we could learn a little more about their business.
I'm in charge of packaging and distributing the product. Every gram comes in and out through that door. I inspect the goods myself. If it doesn't weigh up, colour is wrong, I send the man who delivered it to the farm. The grain doesn't tamper with our products like our competitors do. What leaves this room is the best dough maker in County Durham.
Still confused as to what the gangs actually produce, we return to the street to ask pedestrians.
Hi, excuse me, could you tell us more about the drugs?
You'd have to speak to the baker about that.
The baker? Who's the baker?
Our investigation then turned to finding out who this mysterious baker was. Maybe they could answer all our questions. Eventually, we tracked him down to a bakery.
We tried to speak to the baker, but he wouldn't cooperate. Later, he agreed to meet with us, providing his identity was protected. Okay, let's get started. What's your stake in all this?
My stake?
I mean, you're clearly not some ordinary baker.
My God, you really do think you've got it all figured out?
I think we're closer to the answers than ever before, and that begins with you.
You have no idea. You think this is a game? You come in with your cameras and microphones, and you think you're going to uncover some sort of secret that's been held in Durham for 6 decades? Your children! Children who do not understand the sheer power at work.
Who are you? Which side are you on?
I'm the baker. I'm not on any side. I operate in broad daylight, in the darkest shadows. I know every move you make, and every move you're going to make. But most of all, I'm the one supplying the flour!
The what?
The flour.
Like the plant or...?
No, the powder that you get from grinding grains or roots.
So, the gangs, they're dealing in baking products.
Of course they are. And I'm supplying both sides. It's a fucking gold mine.
So why aren't the police involved?
Because it isn't illegal. Flour isn't dangerous. Not yet, anyway.
What do you mean?
Let's just say phase 2 of my plan was a lot more ambitious than phase 1. Things are getting out of hand, and I'm here to warn you.
Warn us?
Observatory Hill, tomorrow, 11 a.m. The two gangs are meeting for a beast-stalk, but it isn't going to go the way you think it is. Go there if you want to see how this ends.
But it's just flour. They're fighting over flour. It means nothing.
There's a grain of truth in what I'm saying. And you know it.
Following the baker's advice, we went to the hill at 11 a.m. to observe from a safe distance.
This is where the baker said the gangs will be. Oh look, there they are! Are they stupid? They're fighting with bread. Looks like the coast is clear. We'll go and have a look. Well, looks like the brown bread. I don't think gang violence in Durham is going to be a problem anymore.
All right, that's a wrap.